Hello, world. Mr. Resistor here, continuing our Alpha journey. Well, temporarily Omega for a couple days. Anyway, I did buy the 3-day pass so that I could get the rest of the Omega rewards for the release of Revenant. And let's see. Oh yeah. I've got a contract. For some missiles. Go ahead and accept that. That one, since I just got the reminder, let's see if I get my extra 15. Nope. Alright, well, if you are Omega, then you should have an extra 15 skill points. So don't forget to collect those. Okay. Huh. All right. So, check this stuff. Okay, good. Get us our skill points. Before we go out, let's double check here. So, tomorrow, I'll try building that ship and doing some electricals, hopefully. Make use of some of these. All right, so also Vanguard reopens tomorrow. What else? The winter event is coming up soon also. 5th of December, so like a week. Alright, anyway, let's go do this.
Warp drive active. Scope drive active.
Like the updated art for a lot of the modules.
Thank you.
Oh wow, do they keep spawning drones? I feel like that's new. I feel like we definitely did not get as many drones from these guys before. Okay. Let's bring them in. Thank you. definitely want to take this one out next. Arguably, we should take it out first, but... Well, at least there's only warp scrambling me. Happened. Alright, not too bad. Go ahead and collect these while we're here. So I forgot that. That's why. Out the anchoring boss first. I don't actually know if they ever have webs. They haven't so far. But I figure it's better to not take the chance. Kind of a lot of damage to take right at the beginning, which kind of sucks, but I don't know. It is what it is, I suppose. At least I recover quickly. So I am starting to feel like this is a viable way. Possibly. To pay for Omega. This is kind of the situation that I was a little bit concerned about. I don't remember hitting the battle cruisers before. Like, I'm sure I did, I just don't remember it. So I'm a little bit concerned about having the DPS to kill it in a reasonable amount of time while still collecting all the loot. I think as long as I leave my drones on it, should be okay. Yeah, they're definitely taking care of business. Oh, I didn't realize it was the main one. For some reason, I was thinking it was one of the extractors. I do feel like maybe I'm not quite getting as much loot as I did last time, but I don't know, maybe. My brain's pretty fried right now, so I don't really remember much. So yeah, I think it might not be unreasonable to expect I don't know say 50 million ISK per hour if you really got it down. That might be doable. And like I said previously, it might actually be more profitable to not hit the extractors and just kind of blow through as quick as possible. Someone has probably already done that math. I may or may not run my own experiment. We'll see.
Really? Oh no. How can I get out of the rock?
Good thing I've got so much time to spare. That would be, could be an absolute killer. I was not paying attention to my drones. Alright, so anyway, call that 30 minutes for
warp drive active.
15 million. So probably if I was able to get to keep up this pace, then I'd be looking at 30 million per hour. What's Plex at right now? 7 million.
Warp drive active.
Okay, so 5.7 times 500. Divide by 30.
Docking permission requested.
95 hours.
Docking request accepted.
That's doable in a month. I mean, it's still kind of a lot. And hopefully you get your efficiency up. You know, to where you're bringing in more. But like, as a baseline, and this worm is fairly accessible. You know, I mean, it's definitely pilotable as an alpha, and if you were just training directly for it, you could get there reasonably quickly, I think. Yeah. Not an unviable strategy, I'll put it that way. I'm sure that there are better, but, you know. I'm just trying to explore stuff and see what could maybe work. Anyway, that's going to be it for me right now. So, until next time, have a good one.